to that easy proposal, This is IPAC proposal.
That's which correct.
Has been signed by APAC. So it's not easy, easy proposal. Two, there are two parts of the communique. Some of them were unanimously agreed. That is, all those who were present, and let us put on record that 12 candidates contested the 2020 election, and out of the 12, 11 of them were there, and the 11 assented to. So it's not an issue of non-existing party. At least 11 of the 12 that contested 2020 were at the meeting, and they assented to. Three, Sami Jemfi was talking of maybe giving way to the parties. There's a difference between IPAC committee and IPAC meeting. When the current administration came, they constituted a ROPA committee. And he knows that for the ROPA committee, NDC has one rep, MPP has one rep, and all the other parties nominated one person under current administration. So there's a difference between IPAC meetings and IPAC committee. Yes. When it comes to committee, the big parties are given the due recognition. But IPAC meetings, everybody is treated as a member of the IPAC. Again, we are talking of the political parties. You said it, that you should have removed them. It will interest you to know that we did the inspection of the political parties. One, by our assessment, I wouldn't want to put the number of parties that should exist, but 90% plus of them should have been cancelled. But we needed to do consultation with some top legal brains. And what they said was that we have to go to court. But the law does not specify the penalty for them. So as part of our reforms, which is internally, we are trying to amend the various parties with those people we consulted so that we can now give biting teeth to the political party laws. And as long as you have not expunged them from the list, you cannot deny them access. Now, some of the names too, I heard somebody saying that ULP. ULP is United Love Party. They have the slogan, lovey, lovey. Madam Sharon's time, when we launched the...
Oh, Jesus.
when we launched strategic plan, where we introduced the logo, they were there, and the man, I don't know who even of you were there, he said that we were paying monies to media persons who are not members of that party, and we are denying them. So it's not a new party. The headquarters is in Cape Coast, United Love Party. So all the, and you see, there's another, if you look on the list, IPS, it's not a party. It's independent presidential something.
Presidential system.
Okay, so that is joy. So it's for the independent candidate, not for a party. So we should not make a mistake of calling IPS as a party. It is for the independent candidate. And again, we should also understand that whatever decision we are taking now is for 2024. And you and I wouldn't know any of the parties who will contest or not contest. So when you are talking of any reforms, we cannot deny them, because if they did not contest 2020, it does not mean they cannot contest 2024. Mm. Again, forming a political party does not necessarily mean they should be contesting elections. If you look at the constitution, tells you that it helps to shape in the economy something and the rest of the
issue. So it doesn't necessarily mean that. Wants me to ask you this question. Independent candidates, they come in temporarily, contest an election. After that, what is their locus? Why are they at IPA?
You are reviewing an election they contested. And you are coming up with proposals for future elections. So if somebody who has been contested, I think this is the third time, is that you cannot overlook such a person.
I think that's clearly understood.
Anybody who attended a meeting he came out with a lot of suggestions.
Right.
So even the prevention that is there, he brought that issue. Okay. That we should validate to eliminate people who are diseased.
Okay. So,